gonna be servicing my bike. Got a new cassette, some bearings, and some fork seals. Come check this out, guys. Brand new cassette. Same one I have on right now, but the one I have on right now is not working. Came with everything. This is brand new, never been used before. Look how pristine that is. It even came with the little like grease bottle, straight from E13. You'll notice there's no sticker in there because I already put it up on the wall. Next, got some bearings from Real World Cyclery.
Enduro bearings,
guys. These are the good stuff. Now, I know what you're thinking. Where is the bearing tool? I don't have one. What I do have, however, is I got one of these. This is my bearing tool right here. And then I got these fork seals from, it came with my fork. These are probably okay. All right, let's get to it. All right, I'm gonna strip everything, clean it out. Let's get to it. All right, guys, you might have noticed that my current cassette is the same cassette I'm putting on it. The cool thing about these cassettes is the way they're set up in two halves, you can still have this tiny ass gear here. And the way they achieve this 9-tooth gear is by having this half clip onto the bigger half. That way you don't have to shove like a screw down here that holds normal cassettes in. Okay, so there's a trick to getting these cassettes off. Well, I mean, it's not a trick, it's just how you do it. First, you shift in here. Second to highest gear, just like that. Next, you see this little lock right here? You get these two right here. There's the locked state and the unlocked state. And when your cassette's not dirty or worn out, there's a little key symbol right here. You put your chain whip one before the key. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna pedal forward and pull on the chain whip. Just like that. You see that little movement? Now, as we can see, the key is to the unlocked state. And now we can continue taking off the wheel. Now we got the wheel off, and as you can see, our cassette is in the unlocked position. And what you do, you just wiggle it around. This half comes off and it's super dirty. Then we have to unpinch this little pinch bolt. The older ones had a little lock nut here and you had to have a special tool, but they replaced it with this. The whole cassette should just, whoops. That's my, a little too much fell out there. Let's put that back.
What's that centerpiece that's over there?
Don't worry about it.
But that one there.
Oh, this is the bushing.
Oh.
That goes in the top half of the cassette. If you're installing one of these, make sure you have this bushing and that you grease it up like real good.
What's going on?
Bearing pressing is very hard.
What is that? Is that a bearing press?
Hell yeah, it is.
What is that?
Best bearing press.
What the heck?
Me. Okay, I finished up the bearings. So that took a little bit of
four
time.
4 hours.
It did not take 4 hours. Okay, we got super smooth actuation. No noise before they made noise. In fact, some of them didn't even spin. This one, these are the old bearings over here. This one's doesn't spin at all. You can see me trying to spin it. This one spins. These ones are super nice. I am very happy with the install. Okay guys, so I'm here riding the big hit today. Taking a break from building my bike. What the? Bro.
Sorry.
Oh, so the chain kept falling off in the back and I made these little spacers. They replace some of the spacers in the one by conversion and they keep your chain on. If you guys are interested in those, just like shoot me an email. There's a link to contact us page on our website in the description and I'll make you guys some. Because these are nice if you're doing a one by conversion on something that has suspension or the chain's loose or whatever. Yesterday, in the middle of the fork service, we had removed the old seals and we had the new seals and we went to put them in and turns out they were the wrong size. This morning, I went to the shop, got a new set of seals. Now we're gonna finish up this fork service. Hello guys, we're back here, day two. Already serviced the fork. That's all good and ready to go. We're gonna get this beast put back together. Let's get started. The trails bike is looking really fly. Devin's on the full send 29er. This thing's actually epic.
I think my fork stopped working again.
It's fine. No. Here at the halfway point, getting a picture.
I love you so.
We're here at the end of the ride. It's super dark, even though, what time is it?
It's
probably like 5:30.
5:01.
5. Super dark. Finished up the ride. Bike feels amazing. Drivetrain feels brand new, shock feels brand new, pivots feel great, everything is great.
Don't lie, your tire's flat.
Okay, yeah, my tire is flat because I messed up a jump. It still felt good after that.